This is Geoffrey Villa Hardwin. Welcome to the second and final part of the summary of the Antony's Rome campaign. This is a situation from the end of last video clip. So we are controlling most of Italy and up to Mesopotamia, including parts of Africa. So the plan from now on was such that to avoid Imperium, we would allow our allies to make progress, and we will probably stay more or less stationary where we are with the provinces we own. So here is another battle that you have already seen, the siege of Arminium. So we've been attacked by one of Octavian's legions. So that was just a short reminder, and this is the result of that siege. And Legio 13 Herculia, who was defending Arminium, gained in rank. We ambushed an army near Dura that was trying to sneak past Dura towards Myra, and another battle, another ambush. There have been attacks from agents from Octavian in the area of Italy, and in the meantime Helvetii have attacked Lepidus Rome, and unfortunately Pompey has decided to go to war with us and is attacking the fleet that is guarding the Strait of Taranto. The battle says close victory, but in fact we lost no ships and sank both enemy fleets. As a result, our admiral gained in rank. And our research is complete legal documentation, which enhances our research speed. And here is our great leader, Marcus Antonius, with huge array of talents and properties and so on. Better morale for units, higher experience, higher experience rate, higher replacement rate, various anti-agent properties, romanization properties and so on. So there's been an attack there on one of our arms, I think in Arminium, by the Octavian's agents. Here's an attack on Tigranos Serta. This was one of the last few settlements we conquered in the east, in the area of Armenia. It was originally part of Armenia. And an attack on Hadrumetum by Legio 6 Rapax, which took Hadrumetum, and now the road to Carthage is open. Here's again the strategic situation. We are in control also of Tigranos Serta now and Hadrumetum. And we have achieved one of our missions. And a second mission to maintain 100 units in total, 110 units in total. So we got a lot of money from the Senate. We also have, we're about 23 provinces short of winning the game. We also need a few units of infantry, of army, and a number of ships, about, I can't remember, I think it was something like 40 ships more. So this is the strategic situation. Once again, us and our allies, our vassals, this is our part of the Roman Empire. The empire is growing. And I think this is the same mission that we've just seen, 110 units in total, successful mission, a few buildings being built, units being hired, especially to strengthen Legio 4, I think was it Hesperia, Herculia or something, and also building up some ships. Another objective has been issued. And here is the siege of Carthage. So Legio 6 Rapax has attacked Carthage. We have superiority and military superiority, and of course Carthage will fall. And with the fall of Carthage ends our campaign in Africa. Our Legio 6 Rapax gains in rank. Here's the updated strategic situation. Our main enemy in the east is Parthia, and in the west the two Roman leaders, Octavian and Lepidus. And here's the Battle of Nisus. You may remember I have posted this battle. An army of the Belgae has sneaked past half of Europe into Thrace and tried to attack Nisus in Thrace. And one of our armies happened to be there. Legio 1 Adiotrix.
As you command! Over there are Gauls, mead drunk, blood drunk, and pride swollen, ready for a fight. What fools! There is more to battle than a belly awash with strong drink. Soon they will be soaked with fear. Get ready!
Our victory was essentially down to the maneuvers of our general and his bodyguard.
Riders, advance!
Goes silly galloping and jumping, the Olympics a little bit. So here he prepares to skirmish the enemy. His men wish him good luck. Here he has attacked one of the enemy missile units. If you remember, it was blocking one of the roads. Now he takes his bodyguard, attacks the enemy general in the rear. Throws half the next bodyguard to the ground, then pulls out, gets back the other way, jumping over the obstacles. That's how those equestrian sports arose. So now he's galloping to attack the rear of the army of the Belgae, who's engaged here. They're already wavering. Some of their men are retreating. Here his bodyguard throws everyone to the ground. Fantastic charge, and hit by flaming missiles, the Belgae rout. That was a quick end for that battle. So once again, the strategic situation you've just seen, nothing much has changed. The unit, the Belgae that had attached Nisus, now have moved towards former Yugoslavia further north. You can see them there. Pompey controls the three islands of Italy, so Sicily, Sardinia and Corsica, not really Italy. And here is our dominions. And their rate of growth. We are building auxiliary barracks in various places. And an attack by our great leader Mark Antony on Patavium. Mark Antony's legion has far superiority. Here he is, glorious looking in his gold colored armor. Here he is again. And Patavium was taken. So an increase in rank from Mark Antony, we're marching north. We're about to take Mediolanum in Genoa. We are in fact not going to go much further for fear of achieving Imperium. Here Cappadocia has attacked Parthia. So the tactic we're using now is to make agreements with our allies to attack our enemies. And so if they gain territories, that counts towards our total, and we avoid reaching Imperium and therefore crossing our allies. Nonetheless, at this point we had almost perfect diplomatic relations with all our allies and vassals, so it shouldn't really matter. So there's a tribal confederation formed consisting of the steppe factions. Here an enemy legion of Octavian has fallen into ambush. He's been ambushed by one of our legions, Legio 13 Herculia. The construction continues. These are just some examples of the construction where we have lots of things being built. And a silly attack by, or a threat of an attack by Pompey with plebs on ships, it didn't materialize. More building up. Meroe had asked for a peace treaty. We refused. Meroe was pestering Egypt, and here they are besieging Alexandria. And so we sent at this point a division, a legion down to Egypt to help the Egypt out. So we sent our best division, Legio to Augusta, down towards Egypt, and we set also an attack point on Meroe. There's also pledges for peace from Parthia, which we have refused, a defensive alliance with the steppe peoples. Parthia continues asking for peace. Of course, we're refusing. All our vassals in the east are at war with Parthia. There's no way we're going to have peace with Parthia. And here's another ambush. There's another battle that posted, if you remember. This is one of the last few battles. It was an attack. It was a battle between Romans and Romans. So it's the Romans of Antony's Rome against the Romans of Octavian. And the two legions of Octavian have been ambushed. And if you remember, both their generals were singled out. They were out on the limb. Both of them were isolated and killed in battle. So here's the attack on their first general. He's coming with a bodyguard ahead of his legion. There he is. We're attacking him. And he's dead. He's dead in the water. In the meantime, another unit is skirmishing behind us to stop from reinforcements, to stop enemy reinforcements arriving. And in fact, the unit that is skirmishing behind attacked their ballista. And so here's the result of that battle, that ambush. We crashed into enemy legions. We seem to have retreated from Patavium. I cannot remember why. I think it was to avoid Imperium, I think. And so here's Pompey's armies in Sicily. Dacia is asking for an aggression pact, which we agreed to. There's been a war of spies near Meroe, where our Legio to Augusta was campaigning. Mark Antony has gained a rank after that ambush and defeat of those two legions. Here's a ton of new types of buildings being built after some change in research level. So we have lots of grain pits and grain silos and various new buildings that we could not build before. And here's a remarkable naval battle near the end of the campaign. One of our fleets was sailing by Sicily, and it was attacked by four enemy fleets, including, I think, two legions of Pompey and some garrison units that were in Sicily. and there was a massive sea battle, which you are about to witness. So here is our admiral's ship. Here's our glorious fleet in a butterfly shape, which is my favorite formation in large naval battles. It allows good protection to the heavy missile ships, which are in the rear, and it confuses the enemy, because you can see their ships will start milling around when they faced with this type of formation. So here our ballista fires one shot, and it's bullseye on that transport ship. At this point we're aiming and we're attacking their best ships, with the best transports, with the best units, so that they're only left with plebs and spearmen at the end. That's the idea. So now we're strong, we're attacking the best ships. We're of course vastly outnumbered. You can see the balance of forces near in the lower left hand corner. So we sank two ships there, we ran them around another enemy ship here, but for some reason this ship didn't get sunk, and so we're setting out a second trireme, and the second trireme will ram it and it will still not get sunk. So annoying. On the other hand, here we sunk an enemy trireme, and here's another light trireme of ours going to ram an enemy transport ship, and sunk, and then it's given orders to attack a second transport ship. For some reason it got stalled there, and it gave it several orders and it just wasn't moving. And so now the second enemy legion is approaching with their transports, and our light ships on the two flanks are right over. At this point they are lost cause. You can see they have been boarded. I'm sending the heavier ships to their aid. For some reason, Pompey ships are very good. He's got good navy, so we're not doing as well as I was hoping to. Still, the balance of power has got fairly even. We'll stand a chance here. We're hitting that ship. It still doesn't get sunk. So Pompey's navy is very good, but here they have so many ships, they've been bunched up. They cannot board our ships, they cannot do anything, they just bunched up one behind the other. And so that was part of the idea of attacking that fan out formation. Here one of our ships has been boarded by some enemy swordsmen. That's a good unit, so we're gonna have a hard time. This is our admiral's ship, and it's been boarded by plebs. It's been boarded by plebs on this side. I think there are plebs also on the opposite side, but of course the plebs have no hope. So that was part of the plan. We destroyed the best ships, and in the end they were left with the plebs and spear. Nonetheless, they managed to set a couple of our lighter ships apart. So we lost two of our lighter ships. We lose all our lighter ships. But our heavy ships are doing okay. So we're sinking more with heavy missile fire. And here we only have three triremes, and they're really caught in a melee of some kind. And we're trying to disengage, let them free from that measure of transports. But the enemy at this point mainly has spearmen and planes. So we do not. We still have a chance. But the odds are still against us. Back to the action. So we round into the ship, it's sinking. And at this point we're trying to disengage. We only have three heavy melee ships and two heavy missile ships. You see the two heavy missile ships there? And they only have one ship with legionaries. It's this one, and it has one of their captains, admiral, generals or something. It's the only ship that has legionaries, so it's been attacked by our heavy missile ship, and it sank. And now we have a chance. Had they boarded our heavy missile ships, probably we would have lost the battle. I mean, it's still a struggle. It's down now to legionaries versus many, many, many spearmen and plants. Three ships of legionaries against several hundred plants and spearmen. And the odds are even, and you can see we nearly finished this battle, but it was really very, very close until the end. So our admiral's ship is being boarded by more plebs, and it's still close, still even. Plebs are flying in the air, they've been watching the gymnastics and the high jump, the Olympics, and they've got style. Till the odds are even. And finally, suddenly, victory! Victory at sea! At the very last split second, I thought I was going to lose that battle, really. I only had three ships with legionnaires. And they were like half strength, you can see there. And so that was a huge relief and a lesson to Pompey, who dared attack Antony's Rome, breaking our alliance or peace treaty. And so the fleet that won that victory gained a rank. And sadly, a noble death of our general Publius Ventidius Bassus, the general of Legio to Augusta, our famous, our best legion, who was campaigning at that time in Africa near Meroe. And here's the Battle of Edessa. You have also seen in one of the, it was one of the battles that I posted near the end of the campaign, one of the last few battles, you may remember.
This is the kind of battle that I like. Enemies ready to be trussed and stuffed like plump geese. Listen carefully to orders, lads, and we will feast well today. Good hunting.
Our enemies. The Persians.
Soldiers, close watch on those bastards.
Here's a bird's eye view of our glorious legion with the legionaries in the manipular formation in cohorts with a unit of Asiatic archers in the front. Here we are stealthily approaching. And the battle begins. You may remember this scene. To battle, to glory, till victory. Here's that terrible melee, you remember, but we have legionaries on our side and they have Eastern spearmen. I mean, why does the AI fight in this way? Our cavalry is operating in the rear, they are mopping up all their missile units. Here's the general, they are infantry, the spearmen are being breaks. Generals, Bordiga receive a volley of pillar, and everybody in Bordiga is dead, or just about everybody. And that's the end of the campaign. Here's the general, dead, he's died, killed in battle. Glorious death, the last thing of note in this battle, with routing enemy chasing the rocket. The battle was already flash. I don't know if it even lasted a minute. All this marching around for nothing.
Riders, at the devil!
I mean, honestly, these people campaign, they go here and there, they march the length and breadth of Asia and Europe and Africa, and then there are 1 minute battles, and that's it. So, glorious victory with almost no casualties. Kartli was a faction that was at war with us. They asked for a peace treaty. We accepted the peace treaty. In fact, they asked to become vassals, and immediately we reached Imperium. Nonetheless, we had such good relations with our allies, we didn't lose anything. Here was various buildings, especially Romanizing buildings. Over this period, after reaching Imperium, we got some money also from the Senate for achieving some kind of mission. Various many new units, including lots of ships. We need ships to achieve victory conditions. And here's a battle in Zadrakata. An Armenian army attacks the Parthian garrison of Zadrakata. We had a legion this area that was just raiding the area, and it was always near enemy cities that our allies were going to attack, and so it could aid them in battle. That was a trick. So here is the situation with the victory objective. We just need, I think, 13 provinces to achieve victory. And Kartli, I think it was at this point we accepted the peace treaty, and eventually they asked to become vassals. And here, ironically, Rhodes has sent an army to take Massilia, and they've succeeded. So Rhodes, one of our vassals, controls Massilia. Various new types of buildings. There's been a continuous war of agents in Africa, near Egypt, near Meroe and Aksum. There you see them. And here's an attack on, I think, Aksum. We took Aksum and freed Egypt of its last enemy. Oh no, this is an attack in Artaquana, in one of the last settlements we conquered. A settlement in Parthia. It was a dead easy battle. And why am I showing this? I am showing it because Artaquana is just gorgeous. So here it is. Here's the general.
When we have taken this place, and our enemies kneel in chains before us, when their women and children beg for the mercy of slavery, then we will have done a good day's work. Now, to arms!
And so Legio to Augusta, our veteran, famous legion that's been fighting from beginning to end, achieving victory after victory, is about to score one last victory, capture one more settlement in the depths of Asia, in the depths of Persia, Artaquana. One of the most beautiful settlements. So here are some mercenaries. And our ladders are heading for the walls. also have some siege towers towering over. Here the walls of Artaquana defended by just handfuls, pitiful handfuls of men. There are some archers. And so, let the battle begin. Our legionaries are on the walls of Artaquan. The enemy spearmen here haven't noticed yet. They suddenly will dawn to them that they are being attacked here. And now they are going to charge us. Wake up! More fighting the wolves. Biggest threat is the flame arrows being shot from the towers. To their credit, the Parthians are holding their ground. Here's the last Parthians about to be killed. So sad. And more fighting over here where the siege tower has reached the walls. So now that unit of spearmen has been destroyed. There are some more Parthians here. This guy's been thrown over here. The bird has flown into the wall. There's yet another unit here defending the tower. Last unit. They are being massacred as well. Some spearmen with wicked seals. Come on. I don't know what types of units the Eastern factions had at this time, but the AI should have picked something better. So that here's a beautiful scene. The gate has been burned down. Here's that unit that was burned down. The gate is inside Artaquan. And here are some views of the lower class district, working class district of Artaquan. You can see signs of the grandeur, and in the distance, a beautiful palace. So our legionaries are taking us into a tour of that gorgeous city. And as we move towards the city center, it becomes more and more beautiful. That blue lapis-like tiled houses. Here's the beautiful palace. This is so beautiful. Here's a beautiful. Gorgeous palm tree lined streets with some simple houses on the other side. There's a garden in this house. The wall has space, blue tiles. So beautiful. Look at all these palm trees and cypresses. And this is better than being on holidays. And another grand palace in the distance, with an enormous stairway. Here's, I think, their general, or maybe it's the unit. They get absolutely butchered by our legionaries. They all die from the pillar. Here's their general. Being attacked, our legionaries stand his ground, but his fate is sealed. I think it's one with the yellow thing on his helmet. One the other one. I'm not sure. Maybe. Maybe it's one with the final helmet. I really don't know. Maybe it's this guy here with the purple sleeves. It looks different. Has a nice beard. Doesn't look like it's gonna make it. Well, that was their general. Their general is dead. And our men are celebrating. The enemy bodyguard is fleeing. So that was probably their general. They have some more light units here. Some light cavalry. They're shooting some arrows. Other units have fled, they're broken, they're trying to gallop up that beautiful stairway. And that's the battle. Victory in the east, Artacon is ours, who lost a lot of men, but who cares, there can be replenished, who lost no units. And with victory at Artacon, comes victory for the campaign. Victory! Glory! Triumph! Hail Marcus Antonius! All hail our great leader! And so here's the total summary of the campaign and events. You can read them if you like. It was a fun campaign, it was hard, the actual AI was not that hard, either at the campaign level or at the battle level. I'm also not a big fan of the generals that look like some unemployed guys, like rockstar hopefuls or something. But the four main triumvirs, they look nice, they look Italian, they look good, they're well done. And so it was overall a campaign I enjoyed. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you like the battles. I wish they were longer and I wish they were harder. So here is our empire. We achieved victory in light blue. Our allies and vassals were controlling some of the nicest, sunniest places in the world. Here's our growth and public order. I hope you enjoyed the campaign summary. Thank you for watching.